Welcome students, in this session we will learn to draw an angle that is double of a given angle of unknown measure. As you can see, there is an angle here, two arms having the same initial point, or you can call the vertex of the angle. The arms are drawn here, one arm is drawn longer, other one is shorter. Here we are going to construct double of the given angle, and the measure of the angle is not known. We are not supposed to use the protractor to measure the angle and then double the magnitude of the angle and then draw it with the help of protractor. We will have to use the compass to draw it. But here the arm's length are immaterial. They can be extended for the purpose of drawing. So I am taking the arms bigger, so as to be, I am just drawing. I have extended it with a red line like this. It is over the black line only, and another one, the arm is also with the red line. I have extended them. When I have extended the arms, the angle is not going to When I have extended the arm, the angle is not going to change. Okay, the arms can be anything, the angle is going to remain the same thing, whether I draw a line here or here or here, wherever arc, the angle is going to be same. Now I like to take some reasonable distance. Now draw the angle to be drawn. For that purpose I am taking a black line here, because the angle is given angle is in red in color. To just to differentiate, I am using, so I am drawing a line here. I am drawing a long line. This black line means the horizontal arm of the given angle. The left end is the vertex of it. Okay, now I will take the compass, keep it over here. I will set a reasonable distance in this. The compass distance can be reduced to at the least 2.6. It cannot be reduced beyond this. As you can see here, I will take the magnifier and show it to you. The maximum minimum distance that is possible is 2.6. I cannot reduce the length. The distance between the set in the compass less than 2.6. So there is a constraint in that. That is why I am taking it little longer, because I am going to set the compositions to measure the distance between the points of intersection of the arc with the arms. Okay. So I am reasonably taking a longer distance, setting it, which is normally just less than the smaller of the two arms here. I am just taking reasonably this. Now I can draw a arc here. Okay, and you can see it is kept at the left end properly. You can see it's kept correctly at the end, and now I can rotate it and show it to also. It is at the vertex of the angle. The compass pivot end is at the vertex of the angle exactly. Now I will draw an arc. Okay. With the same distance, I will make an arc here too. I will bring the lens over here and show it to you. It is kept properly. It needs to touch it little. Yeah, it's kept properly. Yeah, now it's kept properly. I can rotate it little up. Now I can draw the arc. I have drawn the arc. I taken a little longer line here, because I'll have to draw double of the given angle. Okay. After this, I'll bring the compass over to here. I'll have to reduce the distance And let us set a distance in the compass. How I will be setting the distance that you can see from here. I have pivoted the compass at this point, one of the point of intersection of the arc with the arms. Okay, this point, at this point I have kept it. You can see it. Okay, and I will just set a distance in this compass in such a way that the distance set in the compass is the distance between the points of intersection of the arc with the arms. Okay. Here it is black in color, so it is contrast. There is a contrast, we are able to see it. I'll show it here. It is little up. I just have to minimize it little down. Okay, I'll set it with bare eyes, or I will just magnify and see it. And now you can see it is magnified. Now it is not touching. Now it is just touching. You can see it. It has just touched it. So this is what I wanted. See here. It is there. It is there. It is there. It is there. Just the distance between the points of intersection of the arc with the two arms. That is what the distance between. With this distance, without disturbing this distance, I will just minimize and show it to you what I am going to do next. The same distance will be drawn here too. I will take the compass over to here, where it was initially intersecting. Already it has made a point of intersection with that. So now I will have to draw. Here it is. I'll have to draw one arc here. This is, if I join this point of intersection of the two arcs with the initial point of this horizontal ray, it will be equal to the angle. I want double of it. So what I will do, I'll take the compass over to here, to the point of intersection of the two arcs already done. And from here, it is there here, kept exactly as you can see. I will have to draw another arc here. Okay, so I will just draw another arc here. So now if I join this point of intersection of the arcs with this initial point, the angle formed will be twice the given angle. So this completes this. I am just taking a line here from this initial point. I am drawing a line in such a way it passes through the intersection of the two, second point of intersection of the two arms. It is there here, exactly. So this angle is double of it. If you want, you can check it through using this protractor. You have the protractor here. I kept it here. And it needs to be rotated a little to align with the arms. Okay. Now it is okay. Kept properly. Okay, I just check the angle with the help of the lever here. It is 57.7 degree. I will just take it to here. I'll have to rotate and keep it correctly. I'll take the lens over to here. Yeah, it is kept correctly. Okay. If I bring the lever over to here, 28.6. 28 2 jar 56. Okay. And double of 28.6 is 57.2. So we were measuring 57.6. It is not exactly measured here. It is a, we are actually 28.8. It is. So 28.8 means it is 56.6. We measured 57.7 here. Slight differences are there. It is due to error in measure. So now we have understood it. This completes the exercise. Thank you.